tonight we're using the Prism K12 strategy of synthesize. The definition, the Prism K12 definition, is to make something new and synergistic by combining concepts and skills. And so you can look at the definition, you can look at different examples of what using the synthesized strategy might look like in the classroom, and then you'll get the in the classroom bar describes the lesson that the artwork that is used to illustrate the strategy of synthesize, how it came to be. The Great Migration is a 60-panel series. It's almost overwhelming, the impact that the story has on you. And he painted the series when he was like 23 years old, and he felt like he thought he was too young to be a muralist, that the greats were muralists. You know, Diego Rivera was a muralist, and he thought that he was just too young and too green to be a muralist. So, but he knew he had this epic story to tell with a lot of parts and a lot of details. And so that's why he chose to do it in a series. He was born in New Jersey as his parents migrated up to New York. And so this was a story that he heard in his community growing up. It was obviously something that had impacted the people in his community, but he didn't learn about it in school. And he was really struck by the fact that, you know, he learned about some other important moments in African-American history. And he thought that the Great Migration was not just about African-American history. It's really an important moment in U.S. history that took place over years and years and years and years. And the Great Migration started around World War I and continued and up through the Depression. And then after that, continued again through World War II. And then up and then sort of trickled, I guess, in the 60s. And then in the 70s, there began a reverse migration when a lot of the kids who had been born to migrant parents in the North and in the West decided to go back to places in the South. So Jacob Lawrence got the grant to paint all 60 panels, and he got a little help. His then girlfriend, who would become his wife, helped him lay out all the panels. And his artistic process is mind-boggling. I mean, he did paint the whole thing at one time. They laid out all 60 panels. He had done research. He had already sort of pre-written his captions, so he knew what each panel was going to be. They gessoed every panel. They sketched out every panel. They actually painted the dark stuff first. They painted the blacks and the browns and then onto the lighter colors. He knew 60 panels was going to be sort of a heavy lift for people visually. For 60 panels is a lot to carry one narrative. And so he really limited the palette. And that was the other reason why he painted each color all at one time. So instead of painting, you know, panels 1 through 5 on Tuesday and panels 6 through 10 on Wednesday, he painted, you know, all the green on Tuesday and then all the blue on Wednesday and so on and so forth, because he was making his own tempera paint, and tempera paint changes colors like as fast as you can blink your eyes, because as it dries, the color shifts. And so he really wanted to make sure that the colors in each of the panels was uniform, again, to sort of bring that story, the narrative together. The museum, a couple years ago, we had all 60 panels, created this amazing website. It's lawrencemigration.phillipscollection.org. The cool thing about this website is that you have access to all 60 panels. We're going to look at panel number 9 about the boll weevil. I love his little boll weevil. And there's a great video of Jacob Lawrence talking about his process. So it's a great video, and a number of the panels are accompanied by video. We have a ton of Jacob Lawrence video. And then this particular panel is also accompanied by a letter. our curators did a ton of research at the Library of Congress to find historical letters from the Great Migration. And there a number of them have been uploaded as they are relevant to panels. So if you want to use this website, not only for high quality images and the captions, it's one of the few places where all 60 panels are together. And what you're going to do is you're going to look at the migration series, and I want you to find one that stands out to you. Just choose a panel that you're interested in exploring further, whether it's the artistic process, whether it's the colors, or whether it's the content of the picture, and respond to it using these materials. You might be really interested in exploring Jacob Lawrence's lines and colors. And so you might do an abstract picture that's all lines and colors, or you might want to respond by digging a little more deeply into the content of the picture. So you might be thinking about how people migrate. You might be thinking about discrimination in a certain way. You might be thinking about how in certain parts of the country don't have access to healthy food.
So I was thinking about my family and how we moved to the United States, like trying to think about my family story. And I was thinking about, like, you know, because of me growing up in the United States and learning English and my Lola speaking Tagalog, I feel like I there's a lot of stories that I don't know about. It's important to write these things down and make this art so that these stories are known.
I think that is such an interesting and unique perspective, Christine. It's something that so many people have in common, that their family stories have gotten lost in the immigration process. Everyone's family has gone through something at some point, and just sort of wanting to know what your story is before it's lost.